Grace Nelly Bedijo from Program Associate Food and Agriculture Organizations in Uganda said the plan is to provide practical guidelines to alleviate pressure on the environment and the natural resources, and also ensure sustainable access to biomass for cooking, to building resilience of both refugees and host communities.
To make it up with all the zones, and as well took into consideration a 5 kilometer buffer, because from the past assessment that FAO, UNHCR and other partners had done, there was an indication that this is the extent the refugees move in search of fuel wood energy. So we really had to, you know, take that area as well into consideration.
Antonio Querido, the country representative of food and agriculture organizations in Uganda, said the demand for wood fuel has become a global issue. He calls for collective efforts to implement the launched plan.
Restoration for the decade of ecosystem restoration. We believe that this plan is timely. We do have what the window between 2023 and 2028 to implement. And we have seen that the area that we are is quite vast, and this important plan to provide a tool for us to do it in a very coordinated manner. I think the key for its implementation is coordination.
Michael Joel Nabugere, the OPM settlement commandant in Bidibidi Refugee Settlement, said almost all households in the settlement rely on wood fuel for survival.
A single person in these 190,000 refugees, there are real lives behind the statistics. There are people that are living every day. There are people that are cooking every day. There are people that are surviving every day. And since their livelihoods lack alternatives, since they have alternatives to livelihoods, we see that most of the time, they are relying on the environment to provide for their needs.
People of Uyumbe, to work hard. Let all of us wake up and work in order to become rich. Let everybody produce food and also engage in cash generating activities.
Engineer Hilary Onek, the Minister for Relief, Disaster Preparedness, who presided over the launch of the plan at Yoyo Primary School, said implementing partners and United Nations agencies should design other alternatives for wood fuel in the meantime in order to protect the few remaining vegetation cover.
The mindset to recover, to become humane themselves. Why are we doing this? Because next time they are going back to their country. If they go with the same manner in which they came here, the problem with there will never end. But if they go, they will go as a better human being, better approach in managing themselves in a humane way, accepting defeat, sometimes give and take. If you lose an election, you don't take a spear to spear your friend.
Ministers called upon the technical leaders in the line of ministry to support the plan and ensure it succeeds.
What we call backwards. So please, you technocrats, engineers, no, these are not engineers, foresters and so on. Please, save us from backwardness.
Today, Bidibidi Refugee Settlement is a home to over 190,000 refugees, mainly from South Sudan, according to the recently concluded verification exercise, adding to the over 700,000 host community population of the district. According to a report produced by Food and Agriculture Organizations in partnership with United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, Office of the Prime Minister and Yumbe District Local Government, between 2018 and 2021, the total annual biomass loss within the refugee settlement areas and the 5 kilometer buffer zones around Bidibidi settlement is at 68,383 tons. Report compiled by Adam Gule for the news.